สวัสดีค่ะ This video is about geometrical and optical isomer. In this particular one, we will look at the type of isomer in complex ion. นะคะ. For example, in this exercise question, can the complex ion as shown here show geometrical isomerism? Can it show optical isomerism? When we look at this particular complex ion, it has cobalt as the metal central ion. It has two monodentate ligands, amine, bromo. It has two bidentate ligands, ethylene diamine is a bidentate ligand. We have two groups here. When we have ligand like this, the total coordination number for the metal ion is 6. Count from 1 amine, 1 bromo, and 4 for the ethylene diamine. When we have coordination number 6, the geometry of this particular complex ion would be octahedral, so that the shape of this complex ion would be as shown in this picture here, นะคะ. 6 position around metal central atom. Remember that ethylene diamine has a structure like this. Donor atom nitrogen here will be bond with metal ion. นะคะ. So the position of the ethylene diamine must be in a 90 degree angle. For example, here, นะคะ. Here or here. Alright. To be able to see structure in three-dimensional, you can try to build the structure yourself using simple things like clays and pins in different color, like the one I'm gonna show you here. I use the clay as the metal ion, นะคะ. And I use pin for ligands. The white one here represents bromo ligand, the yellow amine, the red, นะคะ. Together, linked together, the green linked together. นะคะ. You may ask that nitrogen are the same, right? But why I use different color? For this particular video, I just make it simple. Use same color for the one that must be linked together like this. นะคะ. When we put all the pins onto the metal ion, we can make different position like this. The cis and the trans position. On the left here is the trans position. On the right here is the cis position. Ligand, amine, and bromo. This is far away from one another. Amine and bromo here are actually cis near each other, นะคะ. As you can see, these two isomers have this ethylene diamine link together, this ethylene diamine link together, alright? If you would like to draw it on a paper, you would draw it like this and like this. Okay, let me clear the ink for you. Okay, trans. Trans. And cis. Alright. Next, do we have optical isomers for this particular complex ion? For the structure to be optical isomer, we have to have two conditions. Number one, the structure must be mirror image of one another. Number two, the structure has to be non-superimposed. Mirror image, just like on this slide, nakha, this cis structure number one has mirror image like this. When you take mirror image out, you will get structure number two. They are mirror image of one another. They are non-superimposed. Non-superimposed mean the structure are not on top of one another directly. Okay. So we may have position of the green one the same on the right side of the molecules. The position of the white one the same. However, the yellow here stick out. Okay. Where the yellow here go inside. So this are non-superimposed. This number one structure and number two structure are optical isomer. Okay. Let's try again to be sure that you know that they are optical isomer exactly. You may try to rotate the molecules or flip them or make all the position of ligands exactly the same. If you can do it, the structure are not optical isomer, like this trans isomer here. See? When you rotate this particular molecule, now every position look exactly the same. Yellow, green on the right, red on the left, and white at the bottom. So this is not optical isomer. Alright. Compare to the cis isomer that you see earlier. The cis isomer, you cannot rotate to make them look exactly the same. Here you see the green on the right, but this one stick out, this one going inside, okay. So these are non-superimposed mirror image of one another. So this is optical isomer. Okay. Hope you understand it better now. And try to build some model yourself. Bye bye.